7 questions of the session, chopped it up with Chris Cash.
Hey y'all, it's your girl Claire on the beat, and this is 7 questions in a session.
What do you do, HP?
I stay now for 90 days, I bet I came up. I see the money changing, niggas, it won't change us. Pull up, crack the window, you better have it made up. You can't tell me what to do with this paper. No more stairs, I want cribs with elevators. She ain't bought no real money, I see her later. Brody on a speed and a striker trying to.
Yo, play. This your old Caddy Chris, and you are now watching 7 Questions in a Session. Today I got the homegirl, SINCLAIRE Fox, up in here from DELECTABLE Dishes. And y'all already know how we finna do. First thing first, before we get into this interview, go follow our sponsors, Billionaire Hemp Wraps. Treat your lungs better. Spray 420, best cardioterizer out here. And 8 off the bone, men's and female oils. Come get you some so you can get you some. Appreciate you.
He's going crazy.
Hey, appreciate you for coming on the show, man.
All right. I'm super excited to be here.
Yeah, we got her in here for her first interview, and she brought some treats, she brought the drink, man, and we finna get into this interview, man. So, first thing first, I always ask people, like, where did the name come from? Where did DELECTABLE Dishes come from?
Okay, so, basically, DELECTABLE Dishes came from me, like, basically, like, I love food. Like, I love to cook food. I love to taste food. Food is, like, my love language. And when I think about how I want food to taste or what I expect, I want it to be delicious. I want it to be amazing. I want it to be so good that, like, you know, I'm closing my eyes and I'm smiling. So, and just some of the words to describe great, great, amazing food are, you know, just those words. And I'm just like, I don't want something, like, I really went back and forth in my mind, like, delicious and all. I'm like, but DELECTABLE just sounds so, like, amazing. So I pondered upon it for a long time, and I made my mind up. I know that it's something that I can continue. I go so far with. It sounds amazing. I actually had went to the mall, and I'm just like, if you had to go to 2 restaurants, and I gave them the names, I'm like, which one would it be? And it was so many people. It was just like so many people, like, DELECTABLE Dishes. I want to go there. That sounds unique. I never heard nothing like that. So I'm just like, that just, like, confirmed it. It's that.
Yeah. It's, not to go off topic, because we're going to definitely get into the business, mm-hmm. but, like, going through your social media, man, I see you just, like, an all-around hustler. Like where did that come from? Where did that spirit come from? Because, you know, you not only do, like, the catering stuff, but you got a lot of more stuff you do. So, like, where did the hustler spirit come from?
Yes, I am Claire on the beat, so... When I, like, first started, I was working a job. Like, I had been working a job. Like, I had my baby. I was 20 years old. I'm just thinking, like, I don't want to work a job. Like, working jobs is not for me. I can't be here on time. I can't sit at this computer. I don't want to answer the customer service calls and ask them how they doing when I'm not doing good myself. And then, like, so, you know, and once I had to chance to sit back and think, I was giving the company more of myself than I was giving to myself, and it didn't make any sense. So I'm just like, what can I do? I've always loved fashion. I've always loved, you know, getting girly and being cute. And so I'm just like, dang. But and that's when makeup to me, like, it's, I had been getting my makeup done, like, from baby showers, everything. So then I'm just like, but damn, I might as well just do it myself, because I'm just that good.
I see you do makeup. You make, like, custom jewelry.
Yeah, I have.
Kind of do it all. Would you kind of explain, like, I seen the custom earrings. I seen the finger rings.
Yep, so I have, of course, I'm Claire on the beat, but I have on the beat accessories and apparel. So basically, I sell custom bamboo earrings, rings, beautiful jewelry. Like, you know, exotic earrings, like just all types of beautiful stuff. Like, because I'm like a real, like, if it catches my eye, I'm like, damn, I don't know if I think that. If I think it's all, the next motherfucker gonna be like, damn, I think that's cute too. Like, I got that kind of eye. So, yeah, that's how that came along. And actually, the bamboo earrings, which are the earrings with your, you know, a custom name in them, my family is from Philly. So, ever since I was a little girl, you know, I've been going back and forth to Philly. My cousins from Philly, like, everybody, like, so that is the vibe. Like, it don't matter. It ain't about no 70s, 80s, 90s party, none of that shit. They wearing that shit. Like, they got shit with their names on it, rings, necklaces, bracelets. So, I'm just like, I want to bring a feel of where I come from, who I am, and just bring that into my world and where I am, you know? So, yeah, I just started, like, I've always had custom things since I was a little girl. I've had earrings that say SINCLAIRE and bracelets, and so I'm like, that's just, because my mom is from Philly, it's her family, like, that's okay. My mom's side, so it just made it easy to adapt, it made it easy to take on, and once I realized, like, that was what I wanted to do, I just took off with it, on top of the makeup, so it was just like, it was something that came after the makeup.
I want to ask you, like, how do it feel when you see, like, some of these big name social media people buying your stuff?
It makes me so happy. It makes me feel so good. Because, you know, like, honestly, a lot of them reached out off of, you know, somebody else and has paid for their earrings. Like, I have, you know, like, you want to send some stuff out and say, you know, hey, can you wear my stuff? But a lot of them have reached out to me, like, don't, I want to pay, I want to order. So, you know, that kind of stuff just lets me know, like, just to keep on going. People in the city, like, that's cool and that's amazing because I love where I'm from. But when other people recognize it and see it on the outside, it just make me know, like, just keep on going. Don't give up, like, you know? Yeah, and social media also, you know, just plays a big part in it because it makes it more, you know, accessible.
I would say this, coming from a hustler who don't sleep, when do you sleep, P?
I sleep.
Well, it seems like you got so much going on, my nigga.
I have so much going on, and of course, life is always busy. But I mean, like, sleeping, especially at this point in my life, I stay up all night.
For real,
I'm trying to be a millionaire. So I, you know, of course, you have your days where, if you decide to sleep, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like in your mind, even if you laying down, you got your thoughts thinking, you know what I'm saying? Like, you thinking what you going to do for the rest of the day, like what you got to get up and do, you know? So don't nothing come to no sleeper or no dreamer, you know, but dreams. I want to make mine come true.
For real. Mm-hmm. I see some more of that juice. Would you go ahead and explain the juice?
Okay, so basically,
this shit is good as hell, man.
Okay, so this is blue raspberry pomegranate lemonade. So, you know, I just mix a whole bunch of fresh fruit, fresh lemons, you know, like squeeze it in here. What you think? You taste
it? It's good as hell. Shit, I was going to fuck around and drink this whole cup.
Here.
Yeah, so she brought me a plate.
Yeah.
I'm finna let her kind of explain her prices, how you can contact her, and all that stuff. And I'm finna taste test this chicken. This is the first on the show. So I'm gonna give y'all an honest answer, this is the fastest play this chicken right here. I'm high as hell, okay. So it's perfect timing. Mm-hmm. So we gonna go from here.
All right, so this. I'll
definitely show y'all a picture of this, but. Let me put it up.
All right, so this is basically pineapple, mango, honey glazed chicken wings. They're grilled with, like, homestyle ranch. So basically what Delectable Dishes is just great food. I am available. I'm accepting, you know, like, catering, brunching. I love brunch. Honestly, I think brunch is, like, one of my favorites. And, but this chicken is, like, you know, one of my favorites. I think it's different.
It's good as hell, too.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay. So, yes, this is, like, one of my favorites. I love to cook that, and I just wanted to go for a different taste. It is, you know, like, grilled. So.
Man, y'all need to hit that line. I'm going to put the business number up right here in this part of the interview. I'm going to kind of fast forward this part because I'm going to fuck this chicken up real fast. It's definitely good as hell. Y'all need to go holler at her.
What do you do, HP?
I stay now for 90 days, I bet I came up. I see the money changing, niggas, it won't change us. Pull up, crack the window, you better have it made up. You can't tell me what to do with this paper. No more stairs, I want cribs with elevators. She ain't bought no real money, I see her later. Brody on a speed and a striker tryna fade him. You know it's crazy round here. I be thanking God every day I made it round here. We got bums under bridges, it ain't safe around here. I done lost all my niggas, all it took was 1 year. I lost my mind, oh, I'm tripping, think my head gone. I want a busy bro, but he ain't got no.
This is Milwaukee Chris, man. This is a quick break from this interview to let y'all know to please subscribe, like the channel, man. Tell your people to follow. Tell your girl to follow. Tell your mans to follow, man. Get us some subscribers. Get us some followers. Share interview. Yeah, right here. You see it. 7 questions in a session. Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. You can follow my personal page at @CattyCEO_Chris. Follow the channel. 7 questions in a session. Back to this interview. So why don't you go ahead and explain what I'm finna get into right now.
Okay.
This thing look amazing.
So this is ribeye on top of roasted homemade mashed potatoes and garlic lobster tail with a vegetable medley. So basically this is something that I would sell, or you know, something that you could have at a brunch or anything. Just a, you know, a small surf and turf.
Dude, this shit is crazy, man. Obviously, y'all seen the pictures. I'm definitely finna get into this. This, wow. I don't even know what to say. Wow.
You gotta be honest.
I'm finna be totally honest. Dipping this over there. It ain't like strong, like, you know, like that heavy to chew meat. It's so soft and oh my life.
It's good?
Hell yeah. But y'all need to hit that line. I'm gonna put the number up again.
Yeah, you can follow my cooking page. It's brand new, but I'm building it. You know, I'm just following my passion and hoping that it, you know, it leads me in the right direction. But it is DELECTABLE_DISHES_MKE. Or you can always come and check my Instagram out, Claire on the Beat, and all that information will be there. Well, you will always see my cooking. I'm just gonna, you know, become more active and just doing what I really love because it makes me happy.
This is good. I'm going to just let her talk for a second. I'm going to eat them. Yeah, but this is dope.
It's good?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
I make good food, like great food. I do believe that, you know, I feel like I'm a great cook. Judge me. You gotta let me know before, like, cause what if somebody else asks me to come on their podcast after they see yours? Do you feel like they're gonna be pleased?
They definitely gonna ask you to come on once they see this. They definitely gonna.
I'm doing something for the first time that I never seen, and I have been checking your page out, and I'm just like, even though you smoking weed on here like this, I was like, that's the one for me at least first.
Sorry. I appreciate you for sure wanting to come on the show, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so why don't you go ahead and explain what I'm trying now.
All right, so this is our last part, which is the dessert. So I did go ahead and make peach cobbler with homestyle vanilla ice cream. This is like one of my favorite things to make. It's just always perfect.
I ain't had none in a very long time. So we're gonna try it. This, man, the smell coming out the cup. God damn. And you said this is on top of it?
Well, you could just eat it with it. I didn't put it on top, you know, so you can have the option like how you want it.
Damn.
Oh, you like it?
Well, yeah.
Okay, good.
Snap.
Period.
Mm-hmm. What's some of your goals with this, with the business?
Well, my biggest goal is just to be the best at what it is that I do. And just, you know what I'm saying? Just keep being able to cook and do it good. And
who was some of your inspirations? What made you want to start cooking?
Well, definitely like my grandma and my mom. And also like my stepdad, he cooked too. Like those is honestly, like I can't even lie, like the main cookers in my life. Like, well, people that I actually grew and learned from, you know. It's just, I've always watched, and like my grandma used to tell me, be seen and not heard. So, you know, they was always talking about the adult stuff in the kitchen. So, you either just be seen, like you ain't condoned, but I wasn't just listening to what they were saying. Like, I'm watching. My grandma cooked so well. Like, she got so many recipes that I just got memorized just off a visual, watching her cook. You know, my mom, too. Interested with every, like, cooking is just a thing for me. Eating is a thing for me. I don't know.
Since this is a music show, normally, I'm going to ask you one music question. Who your favorite artist from here right now?
Gosh.
I had to put her on the spot.
You putting me on the spot right now? Mm-hmm. Honestly, I don't have no, I don't want to sound like that, but I don't have no, like, I wouldn't say no favorite. I'll listen to anything, everything, like.
Okay.
But I don't even got no playlist.
Yep, you gotta get the 7 questions playlist. You got iTunes?
Yeah.
Listen to iTunes. Yep, you gotta get the 7 questions playlist. Yep, I would definitely send it to you. Man, so if somebody wanted to book you for a catering job, what would your prices start at?
I wouldn't say prices. That is something that, you know, you discuss with your customer based upon, you know, what they need, you know? So I don't want to just be like, oh, I'm charged this, whatever. Like, you can have a big party, you can have a small party. It's basically just, yeah, based off what you need.
All right, well, shit, this part of the interview, I always say the camera on you. Once you let everybody know, again, your social media, if you have a business number, the business pages, whatever you want them to know, camera on you.
Okay, so you could follow my personal page, my business page. Well, my business page is DELECTABLE_MKE. Claire on the beat, that's me. It's also my Instagram. And you can reach me. Well, you can also just DM my page. Like, if you want anything, if you need anything, I'm going to be posting on there daily sales of peach cobbler, you know, just food, just really trying to get a feel for what you guys like. I am here for you. I have so much that I want to cook and just have other people explore, because I really, really love good food. So I want other people to love good food, and I want to keep being able to provide good food.
Yeah. Y'all go shop with her ASAP. I'm your well caddy, Chris. Thank y'all for watching 7 Questions in a Session. Again, go follow our sponsors, Billionaire Hemp Wraps. Treat your lungs better. Spray 420, best cardioterizer out here. And 8 Off the Bone, men's and female oils. Come get you some so you can get you some. And subscribe to the channel, man. We almost there. We almost to that threshold. Help us turn this hobby into a hustle. Yeah, we up out of here, man.
What it do, HP?
I stay now for 90 days, I bet I came up. I see the money changing, niggas, it won't change us. Pull up, crack the window, you better have it made up. You can't tell me what to do with this paper. No more stairs, I want cribs with elevators. She ain't bought no real money, I see her later. Brody on a speed and a striker, tryna fade on.